The face-to-face meeting between President Geingob and IPC leader Itula is the first since the two battled it out for the presidency during the 2019 presidential elections. Though votes were spread across 11 candidates, eyes were fixed on Geingob as the ruling party candidate and Itula as close challenger, who obtained 29% against Geingob's 56%. The IPC leader then went on to challenge the results and the use of the electronic voting machines in court, but ultimately conceded when the courts upheld the results pronounced by the Electoral Commission of Namibia. The two leaders have since exchanged pleasantries on various platforms, both hailing Namibia's democracy.
When you ask for criticism, that's how we are supposed to do. I always say people go to war when diplomacy fails. When you don't communicate, you don't know one another. We suspect each other on a thing that you could have met and resolved. That's why I'm happy as Namibians, first and foremost. We have political parties everywhere that's happening. But we are Namibians, first and foremost. This is the only country we can say it's our home. So I'm really glad to see you here, as I said, for the first time.
It's the only country we have, and we adopted a collaborative approach to politics in this country, recognizing the commonality of the wishes of the people of Namibia for prosperity, whilst respecting the dignity of everyone else. We also avoid confrontations, and if there is any words that denies or infringe upon the dignity, especially of Your Excellency, that is not within our policy. In addition to that, as I said, and we adopted that policy, every public meeting that IPC will be having, the first thing that we recognize is respecting our head of state. We believe that the institutions we have in this country must be respected.
The IPC also applauded the government for managing the COVID-19 pandemic and other disasters caused by the economic downturn. The party pledged to help ensure that national programs are implemented despite different political affiliations.
I think that with all that has taken place, we emerge victorious, and thanks for the manner in which you steered the ship with your team as well, taking into consideration the entire health requirements of our nation, at the same time, the health of our economy as well. And we understood that Your Excellency and your team are seeking to find a way to get our economy on the rails again, a difficult task indeed, which we hope to share in and to get a better and clearer understanding.
We have been really going through difficult times ever since we took over the office. We had a downturn in the economy of the world. It affected us, Angola especially. As we are trying to navigate out of that, we had severe drought. Worst drought, so to say. Again, trying to survive, bang! What I would call this uninvited enemy called COVID-19.
So we actually need to find a way that we can ensure that decentralization works in practical terms, and it doesn't end up being kind of killed by the political stalemates that we may be engaged in. So we are hoping that at that level we will hold one another's hands.